Thanks, Zach.
Hello, everybody. I'm Burns Hargis for another edition of Inside OSU. What kid has not wanted to ride on a fire truck and be a part of this exciting profession? Well, here at Oklahoma State, this is the best place in the world that you can be trained. We're called the West Point of Fire Protection and Safety. And this is a 1951 American LaFrance, which was totally restored by our students over the last year or two. We're going to go inside and see what goes on here, but we appreciate Zach Thompson from Seminole, Oklahoma Driver. We'll talk to you inside, Zach. Let's go have a look. Well, here I am in the pump room of our Fire Protection and Safety Division, and with me is Mike Larranaga, who's an associate professor and is the head of this program. Mike, welcome to Inside OSU.
Thank you.
This whole program has been called a national treasure. And I think the history of it's very interesting because most people are surprised, actually, to see the extent of the fire protection and safety programs we have at Oklahoma State. How did it get started?
Well, it got started when, in 1931, the insurance industry called to Congress in Stillwater with the Stillwater Fire Department to better train firefighters and validate the training that firefighters have.
And why Stillwater? Something about the fire chief here was...
The fire chief, Ray Pence, was friends with several executives in the insurance underwriting industry. And
I guess they've had a lot of losses and they want to figure out how to do a better job both on the front end and in fighting the fires. Huh?
That's right.
So what happened then?
So as a result of that, they started having a conference every year, and that led to Fire Protection Publications and the International Fire Service Training Association. And they're the largest publisher of fire training materials in the world. And that also led to the academic program, which at that time was called the Department of Firemanship.
This is not a common program in universities around the United States, is it?
No, there are very few programs like ours.
How many?
Well, there are two that are ABET accredited in the United States.
ABET?
ABET accredited.
That's American?
Well, it's what is formerly known as the American Board for Engineering and Technology, and that's an accreditation that allows our students to take the professional engineering exam.
How many students do you have?
We have about 250 students.
And what is the academic curriculum for them, generally?
We have a four-year program with in engineering technology, and they take basic engineering science courses, and then we tailor a special course in fire protection, safety, and industrial hygiene for our students.
And this is not just fire, is it? I mean, it's broader than just fire.
It's broader than fire, and we really are a loss prevention program, and we teach students to prevent losses in industry, manufacturing, and municipalities, government.
So any kind of disaster in a building or on a ship or on an airplane, we're teaching our students how to prevent that, design them in a way that will prevent that, and if it happens, what to do about it.
That's correct.
That's incredible. What are the career opportunities? I would think in this day and age, they'd be incredible.
We have amazing career opportunities for our students. And each student enjoys multiple job offers, and even in this down economy, we don't have a problem placing students.
And just as I said, this is a national treasure. We actually guard and protect some national treasures in the U.S., right?
That's correct. Well, all around the world. But we are recognized for the contributions of our students in protecting artistic and cultural treasures in the United States.
What are some examples?
The Smithsonian Institution, the Statue of Liberty, the U.S. Capitol Complex, the Supreme Court Building. Library of Congress, the rare books collections at Yale University and Harvard.
Wow.
And even OSU Edmund Lowe Library.
Well, I know it's a very dedicated and loyal alumni group because I hear from them a lot and they're very interested in this program and we're very interested in them as well. We're going to look at some more things around here. The pump lab is for what?
These are installed in buildings and industrial facilities and things like boom picking stadiums. And if a sprinkler is to be discharged as a fire sprinkler or there's a fire, the fire pump will turn on to deliver water and help control the fire until the fire department arrives.
So the students are learning how these things work and how they're engineered?
That's right, how to design them, install them, take care of them, keep building safe. In addition to the fire pump lab, we also have a fire systems laboratory where students learn about the different types of sprinkler control valves that we have. In addition, we have a fire alarms lab where students learn about detection and alarm systems for different types of fires and different types of detection such as smoke and heat. Within these laboratories, we have people that come from all over the world to take continuing education and outreach courses, and we probably have 30 to 40 courses a year, and these are professionals from all over the world working in the fire and safety industries.
Well, you, in this state-of-the-art facility, we have other demonstration and labs, in effect, for our students, and one is the burn lab. So we're going to go in there. This is one of the places where you do what you're never supposed to do, and that's set something on fire, right?
That's right. Well, we want to do it in a controlled setting so no one gets hurt and nothing burns down.
All right, great. Well, we'll go into the burn lab now and see what that's all about. Well, now I'm in the fire dynamic lab room. It's also known as the burn lab. For these purposes, we'll call it the Burns lab. And I'm with Laura Gross and other students from Fire Protection and Safety. In fact, let's introduce everybody right quick. You have to kind of speak up.
Benjamin Eschner, and I'm from McHenry, Illinois.
Okay, and what year are you?
I'm a junior this year.
Junior.
I'm Benjamin Craig, and I'm from Uniontown, Ohio. I'm also a junior.
Ohio, Illinois.
Patrice Barnett from Brighton, Colorado, and I'm a senior.
You're a senior, Brighton, Colorado. Laura, we're going to talk to you in a second. Andy?
I'm Andy Emerson. I'm from Chattanooga, Tennessee, and I'm a sophomore this year.
Zach, this is our driver. This was the guy that brought in the American LaFrance.
I'm Zach Thompson. I'm from Seminole, Oklahoma, and I'm a senior this year.
We put out the fire, didn't we?
Yes, sir.
Never got started. How about you?
I'm Aaron Geyer from Stratford, Vermont.
I'm Rhett Strain from Abita Springs, Louisiana. I'm a junior this year.
You get the idea this is a national program. I mean, Laura, how did you end up here in Oklahoma from Salida, Colorado?
Originally, I wanted to be a firefighter, so my dad and I sat down and did some research on where I could get a bachelor's degree that would better be of use in the fire program. So we found Oklahoma State, and I moved down here, and once I started classes, I realized that there was more to the program than just firefighting, and now I would like to become a sprinkler designer.
What do you think the career opportunities are?
I can go safety or protection, firefighting. The possibilities are endless.
Rhett.
Yes, sir.
This is a real Ghostbuster outfit.
Yes, sir. Absolutely.
The ghosts we're gonna bust are the fires.
It's
right?
The flames. Yes, sir.
We're in front of a set here. I guess I'll call it.
Yes, sir.
Burn. Tell us about this.
We've got a living room setting burn prop here. We've got a recliner couch that we're going to place some flammable liquids on to imitate an arson fire using flammable liquids. We're going to watch the growth stage, take a bunch of temperature readings, watching how fast different materials are going to react with the fluids and the heat of the fire, and watch the spread.
Good. Well, let's have a look.
Absolutely.
Yeah, I'm glad I didn't sit in the chair. So, Rhett, what are you learning? What are you learning from this other than the chairs burning up?
Basically, what we're learning here is watching the fire growth. As you can tell, it's going to go up, hit the ceiling. It's going to spread across the couch itself. It's going to start into the walls. You'll start hearing picture frames and things like that breaking. We're also taking some measurements here on our temperature scale. And it is, as you can tell here on this black line, which is our back wall where the picture frame is, we also have some ceiling and the east wall. We also have some on the back wall. As you can see, the wallpaper starting to burn and things like that. This is all the types of measurements we're looking at.
Is that wall built like a regular wall
would
be in a house?
The only thing missing in this wall is insulation, just because of the toxins in it. We didn't put any. So you can feel some of that radiant heat. You'll also start to get trash cans and things like that around it to burn. You can see where it's now hit the ceiling, starting to roll out.
Now, in arson investigations, can they tell where a fire started?
Yes, sir. Origin is fairly easy to tell. You're gonna have high heat. As you can tell, the glass just broke from our picture frame at high temperatures. But back to the arson investigation, you can tell point of origin fairly easy because of the amount of heat, and things are going to be charred fairly well. And
it's putting out a lot of heat, I'll tell you that.
It does get fairly warm, and once we're done, you can actually go back through and look at the records. Like our west wall right now, we're at about 1,500 degrees. I mean, that's a tremendous amount
of heat.
Feels
that much here.
Yeah, and the ceiling, we're at about 2,000 degrees. So up at top, you're looking at about 2,000 degrees.
I see.
But we'll go ahead and step back and we'll let these guys go ahead
and
attack the fire.
Great. you guys started the spray up high. Is
yes,
that
sir.
What you do?
Yes, sir. Depending on the types of fire, you're going to either attack it high or attack it low. With ventilated fire, you want to cool the upper atmosphere because you have a place for all that temperature and steam building up. Because as you can tell, boiling water, you're going to start to put off steam. At 2,000 degrees, you're going to steam water fairly fast, and that's where your heat's going. So you're going to attack it high and work start to let that steam roll down on top of it.
I see. Well, as you can see, it's a pretty dramatic profession, and we're glad they're studying it. OSU has a long history of protecting the public from fires and other disasters, and this Fire Protection and Safety Unit right here at Oklahoma State University is the true leader, as they said, a national treasure. So for Mike Larranaga and all of these students, that's another edition of Inside OSU. We'll see you next time.